So this evening is about how do we protect these little creatures. They are caterpillars, and I have a tree, and all they eat are those leaves around that tree in order to survive. And after they've eaten enough, they go into their cocoon and they become butterflies. You know, they stay in the cocoon a very long time. So it's almost like how many will make it, and you know, so it becomes like a tragedy, you know, because they don't all make it. Like right now it's raining, you know, severe rain, so they may not even make it through the night. Now, it's exciting though, I have four of them, and they are the giant swallowtail. I ID'd them, the giant swallowtail butterflies, and I'll put that image out. Now, they're very exciting to have in the garden. I've seen them over the summertime, but to lose them would be awful. And there was a passerby saying, those are worms in your tree and they're killing it, they're gonna kill your tree. And I said, no, they will, but I prefer the caterpillar and the butterfly later, you know. There's a point where, you know, there is a coexist, you know, the tree can handle quite a bit, even in sparse condition. So the drama is the human being's reaction to the tree, like, fix it, you know, pour poison on it to kill those things, make sure they eradicate and never come back and all of that. Those humans are doing that. I did find out somebody will put neem or something, but in certain cases, I mean, I have like antique butterflies from like 1777 first discovery around. You know, these are incredible creatures, and here they are. I know, not first discovery, but first discovery. Like somebody said, that was when they were started in their genome. Databases, but the problem is the human beings are so dullard that they're not aware that the caterpillar is oftentimes a very beautiful butterfly later and offers many things to the garden. Is a nectar collector, is a pollinator. Lots of things are going on, you know, with these butterflies. So instead of going, oh, that's so ugly, get rid of it, it's actually eating my trees out and they're not gonna survive, you know, big panic, you know, go to the last bit, you know, and hope. I mean, the leaves will survive, the leaves will just recover, they'll just grow another leaf, you know. It's like, well, it's just been one of those years, you know, I don't have very many leaves. But yeah, I mean, we prefer to have the pollinator swallowtails and these beautiful butterflies out there. So anyway, that's all I guess I have to say tonight, is drop your eradication trip and, you know, just deal with the sparsity of a plant that has to exist. I know certain cases when you get too many, you get like those, they're like the tent caterpillars, or they get 100 of them or something. Those are annoying. But like, there are easy ways. There's hot soapy water for them, or there's like somebody was saying, the neem oil, you can spray that on. You know, certain cases you don't want those particulars in excess. But giant swallowtails, that's another story. You know, and when I have, you know, just regular human beings already wanting to kill them, I just kind of was a sickener. So anyway, there's a notice of what they look like, and no, they're not that amazing, but they're large. They are large. They're not as large as some of them, but they are about so. All right, so I'll leave the photo out there.